And therefore, here the pronoun I am is used for Atma. Atma does not have anatmatvam. Therefore, it cannot have limitation. So how nicely, how brilliantly this word I am is being explained here to clarify this fellow also. Even Nayayika, Vayakarana also require clarification. Vedanta is not to they have to educate everybody. Even the grammarians also need to be educated. And Nayayika, everybody need to be educated as to what a given thing means, really. The only one who is clear is the Vedantin, because he is clear about the ultimate reality. And as much as Vyakaranam, Nyaya, Vaishya, whatever it is, ultimately must evolve from that. And so clearer you are about the ultimate reality, clearer you will be about every science also. So Vedanta can have his Chanchupada and everything, you know, Vedantin. And therefore he can boldly enter the realms of Vaisheshikas and Nayayikas and Mimamsakas and Vayakaranas and so forth, and therefore can debate, you know, with everybody. But anyway, so this I am, Ghataha, I am Pataha, so Ghataha Pata is limited not because it is referred to by the pronoun I am, but is limited because of it being Anatma. Therefore, nishesha anatma tadhetu nirakana vartmana. But what is atma? How do you arrive at atma? You arrive at the atma by totally negating. So vartman is a path. So by the process of negating, everything that is anatma, nishesha anatma. So anatma in its totality, tadhetu along with the hetu, that is ignorance. So anatma along with the hetu, when it is completely negated, only by then you arrive at the Atma. Therefore, Atma does not have even a trace of Anatma naturally. Atmatvam Atmana Siddhet. And that is how the selfness of the self becomes established, accomplished. Na Ananyashesham Anatmavata. And therefore, Ananyashesham. Na Anyashesham, sorry. Na Anyashesham Anatmavata. So anatma is anyashesha. Anyashesha means what? That which serves the purpose of something else. Or that which is meant for something else. So anatma is always meant for atma. Anatma is that which serves the purpose of atma. The jada is that which serves the purpose of chetana. Bhojya is that, or bhogyam is that which serves the purpose of bhokta. So bhokta and bhogya, the eater and the eater. So eaten is a food. Food is that which serves the purpose of the eater. So this is a general rule, that jada or inert is that which serves the purpose of a conscious being. So everything inert is anatma. So anatma always serves the purpose of atma. Anatma is that because atma is, in short. Even if you don't just serve the purpose, then also all we can say is anatma is because atma is. And atma is because atma is. That's all. So anatvat nanyashesham. Therefore, anatvat nanyashesha, dependent upon something, serving the purpose of something, whereas atma is not dependent upon anything, does not serve the purpose of anything, and therefore, it is not limited. So what is limited? Limited is that which is anatma. Why is it so? Because anatma is always meant for something else. Anatma is always meant for atma. Everything in the world that there is always meant for something. Otherwise it cannot exist. Atma is the only one that is not meant for anything, and still it exists. In the creation, nothing can exist unless it serves a purpose. Ultimately serves the purpose of whom? The whole creation is revolving around what? Ultimately Atma alone. So everything revolves around, so what that which revolves around, like earth revolves around the sun. So there is a reason, you know. Earth is subservient to sun, dependent upon the sun, therefore it keeps on revolving. Anyway, in different ways you can say the idea is that everything in the creation is found to serve a purpose for somebody. And ultimately that somebody will be, in the ultimate sense, will be none other than Atma. And whose purpose does the Atma serve? Nobody's purpose. Everything is because Atma is. Atma is because Atma is. And therefore, I am refers to anatma, or I am usually refers to something that is limited, because It is not because it is referred to I am, but that which refers to is anyashesham, that which serves the purpose of something else, and that which is classified as anatma. So a ghatapada is limited not because it is referred to as I am, it is limited because it is anatma, as well as it serves the purpose of atma. Therefore. This is the tika. Katham anatma tadhetu nirasadvara atma siddhihi. Katham anatma tadhetu nirasadvara katham atma siddhihi. You say that, so nishesha anatma hetu tad nirakarana vartmana atmana atmatvam siddhet. That the atma is atma can only be established only when the whole of anatma and its cause have been negated. How? Katham anatma tadhetu nirasadvara atma siddhihi. So how is it that the atma is siddha or established by nirasa, by negation of anatma and its cause? Atma atiriktasya kaya karanavastana sattvat. So alright, even if you remove all the anatma, still the jagat remains. That's what you mean, you know. So atma atiriktasya kaya karanavastana sattvat. As the Sankhyas would say, so those who look upon the world as reality, as real, so they would say that the world, which is of the nature of karya karana, enjoys a reality of its own, and therefore it enjoys its own satta. So therefore, anything that is dependent upon the atma can be negated. But when something stands apart from atma, something that stands independent of the atma, so how do you negate that? So that's why, even, so atma atiriktasya karya karana vastuna sattva. So this karya karana vastu that is different from the atma, when it is there, so even if you deny or negate everything that is anatma and the cause of anatma, still the jagat of the nature of karya karana will remain. So how will you arrive at atma? Iti asankyaha asadharana iti. So the next verse. Asadharana siddhyaiva siddhyasyat atmavastunaha yataha. अतः आत्मवस्तु एव कार्य कारण वह जगत. That's interesting. So असाधारण सिद्धियाँ एव सिद्धिस्यात् आत्मवस्तुनः यतः. अतः आत्मवस्तु एव कार्य कारण वह जगत. So the tika says अद्वितीय स्वप्रकाश आत्मनि जगत अध्यासात् तत्पूर्णता युक्ता इत्यर्थ. अद्वितीय स्वप्रकाश आत्मनि जगत अध्यासात्. सो अतः कार्य कारण जगत आत्मवस्तु एव. In short, the Vartikara wants to say that the Karya Karanava Jagat does not stand apart from Atma. It is not different from Atma inasmuch as, so it doesn't enjoy an independent Satta. And so it is something that is superimposed upon the Atma. So, Ataha Atmastu Eva Karya Karanava Jagat. So Karya Karanava Jagat also is not separate from Atma, and therefore, when Anatma is negated, that also becomes negated. So, like Sankhyas, we do not say that the Karya Karanava Jagat is independent. So, Asadharana Siddhya Eva Siddhisyat Atvastunaha. So, Atvastu is what? Asadharanam. I guess, so that which is the Karya Karanava Jagat, so that is the Asadharanam and Sadharanam. So that universal and the particular, you can say. So, like the gold and the ornament, so ornament can be called the asadharanam and gold is called the sadharanam. So asadharanam and sadharanam, so asadharana siddhyaiva siddhisyat atmavastuna yataha. That's interesting anyway. शेष अनात्म तद्धेतु निराकरण वर्तमाना आत्मत्वम् आत्मनः सिद्धेत. सो असाधारण सिद्ध्या एव आत्मवस्तुनः सिद्धिस्यात्. अतः आत्मवस्तु एव कार्य कारणवत् जगत है। कार्य कारणवत् जगत इज दैट विच इज असाधारण एंड इन द कार्य कारणवत् जगत दैट इज साधारण और यूनिवर्सल इज आत्मा एंड देयरफॉर आत्मवस्तु न सिद्धि स्यात् असाधारण सिद्धिया। हाँ ओके, व्हाट इट मीन्स इज दैट असाधारण सिद्धि मीन्स व्हाट, एनीथिंग असाधारण कैन एग्जिस्ट ओनली व्हेन साधारण मीन्स। सो लाइक द ऑर्नामेंट कैन बी देयर ओनली व्हेन द गोल्ड इज, अदरवाइज ऑर्नामेंट कैन नॉट बी। सो असाधारण सिद्धि मीन्स असाधारण ऑफ एनीथिंग पर्टिकुलर। सो एनीथिंग पर्टिकुलर कैन बी देयर ओनली व्हेन द यूनिवर्सल इज देयर। सिमिलरली ऑल्सो द कार्य कारण जगत, जगत कैन बी देयर ओनली व्हेन समथिंग यूनिवर्सल इज देयर। And universal is something that is superimposed upon the particular is something that is superimposed upon the universe, just as ornament is there which is superimposed upon the gold. And similarly also the karyakarana jagat is something that is superimposed upon the Atma. So this is how the Vedantists look upon the relationship between the universal and the particular. So according to Nayayikas, both of them will belong to the same class. But according to Vedantin, the particular is that which is superimposed upon universal. Inasmuch as we don't look upon gold and ornament as something different, the Nayayikas actually distinguish them. They would say that the universal is one and particular is another one. But then you can't distinguish the gold and the ornament, take away the gold, ornament doesn't remain. So we say that the particular is that which is superimposed upon the universal. So whole Karya Karanava Jagat also can be established to be there, it can exist only when something universal is there. Inasmuch as a particular is superimposed upon the universe, therefore the Karya Karana Jagat is superimposed upon the Atma. So asadhana siddhyaiva siddhisyat atmavastunaha yataha, this is general rule. So yataha atmavastunaha asadhana siddhyaiva siddhisyat. So when asadharanam is there, sadharanam must be there. When particular is there, universal must be there. Atah, atmasto eva karyakaranavat jagat. Therefore, this karyakaranavat, this jagat, which is possessed of the nature of the cause and effect, that itself that is there, itself shows that atma is, because all of that is superimposed upon the atma. So, the relation here is between adhisthana and adhyaropa. अद्वितीय स्वप्रकाशात्मनि जगतः अध्यासात् तत्पूर्णता युक्ता इत्यर्थः। सो बिकॉज अनन्य बोधमानत्वात् आल्सो इट वाज सेड, सो अद्वितीय स्वप्रकाश आत्मनि, आत्मा दैट इज अनन्य एंड देन बोधमान, अनन्य इज अद्वितीय एंड बोधमान इज स्वप्रकाश। So ananya bodhamanatvat, since the Atma is so non-dual as well as the nature of consciousness, so prakasha jagadah adhyasat. So all the dvaita is superimposed upon the advaita, and all the jada is superimposed upon the prakasha, and that is how jagadah adhyasat tat purnata, therefore Atma is purna. The idea is that, see, if jagat stood apart from the Atma, then Atma cannot be purna. If Atma, that is consciousness, is one, and the Jagat is something that is different, even though Jagat is Jadam, and it is whatever it is miserable stuff, let us say. But still, if he stands apart from the Atma, then Atma becomes limited by it, because that Jagat is Atma is not, and therefore Atma will become limited. Therefore, nothing can stand apart from Atma. Atma stands apart from everything, but nothing can stand apart from Atma. Nothing can stand apart from Atma, therefore Atma is all pervasive, immanent, and Atma stands apart from everything, therefore Atma is transcendental. So there are both the aspects. Atmani jagatah adhyastatvam samarthayate. That jagat of the universe or the creation is superimposed on the Atma samarthayate. So that is supported here by the reasoning nahi iti. Then the next verse is nahi idam atmanah sthanam tata anyatrapi va ashnude atmanah avyatirekena yatah anatma prasiddhyate. Nahi idam atmana sthanam. That's, you know, that's an interesting language here. But the idam means idama prakrutam jagat nirdishyate. Idam means jagat. So nahi idam, idam is jagat. Idama prakrutam jagat nirdishyate. This jagat is naha atmana sthanam. It is not where atma is. So in short, jagat is not that which is identical to atma. Tata anyatra viva nasnude, nor does the jagat stand something anyatra, separate from atma. So sannapya sannapya vyatmikano, bhinnapya bhinnapya vyatmikano, maya of the jagat cannot be said to be bhinnam or abhinnam. You cannot say that jagat is separate from atma or one with atma, like the rope snake. We cannot say the snake is different from the rope, nor can we say the snake is one with identical to the rope. And therefore, that snake cannot be categorized in any known category. Therefore, we say the snake is adjusted, superimposed upon the rope. So, nahi idam atmahasthanam, tata anyatraviva nashnute. And so, this idam jagat, it is not something that is identical to atma, nor is that which stands apart from atma. And na atmana avyatirekena yatah anatma prasiddhyate. Yatah, since anatma cannot exist something independent of atma, therefore it is superimposed from the atma. That's the idea here. See, uvayatr hetumah atmana haiti. So, two things are there. Nahi idam atmana sthanam is one statement. Tata anyatra vivana snute, another statement. And the hetu is what? Yatah anatma atmana avyatirekena na prasiddhyati. That's the hetu. So, that's what the Tika says. Nahi vyatireka avyatireka abhyam anatma siddhihi. Nahi vyatireka avyatireka abhyam anatma siddhihi. Anatma cannot be said to be vyatirika, different from the atma, avyatirika, one with the atma. Vyatireke nisvarupatvat. If anatma is too totally separate from atma, then it becomes nisvarupa. Because atma is a very atma. Atmana, so aprasade. So that is why I have to say it also. That samsare prasade yoyam atmana. So this is a very atma, the very essence of samsara. The very essence of anatma. And therefore, if anatma stood apart from the atma, it would cease to exist. If the gold, the same thing with the golden ornament also. Is ornament one with gold or is ornament separate from gold? You cannot say ornament is one with gold because gold can exist without the form of the ornament. Nor can you say ornament is separate from gold because it cannot exist apart from gold. So ornament is not gold because gold is independent of ornament. Ornament is not apart from gold because gold, and ornament cannot exist apart from gold. You see, gold can exist or gold exists apart from ornament, therefore ornament is not one with gold. But ornament does not exist apart from gold, therefore ornament is not separate from gold also. So, matsani sarvabhutani nachaham tesho vastitaha. They are all superimposed upon me, therefore they cannot stand apart from me. Nachaham tesho vastitaha. I am not dependent upon them, therefore I stand independent of them. This is the relationship, and that always is brought up again and again and again. It is this kind of viveka that is to be done. Everybody thinks atma anatma viveka means atma standing apart from anatma. You know, that kind of viveka is not meant. Either anatma is completely negated, then atma stands by itself, or atma stands as a substratum of the anatma. When anatma is there, then also atma is as a substratum. When anatma is not, atma is as that which transcends it. So, nahi idam atmana sthanam. You know, that's an interesting way of saying. This jagat is not atmana sthanam. It is not where what atma is. Tada anyatra viva nashnute. Nor it can obtain apart from the atma. Yataha, because anatma, atmana, vyatirekena, na prasiddhyate, na has to be brought here by the way. So na prasiddhyate, because anatma cannot exist apart from the atma. Therefore the Tika said, nahi vyatireka avyatireka abhyam anatma siddhi. Vyatireke Nisvarupatvat. If the ornament stood apart from gold, it would cease to be ornament. Nisvarupam. Because gold is Svarupa. Avvitarekasya jada jadayoho ayogat. That's another way of saying, you know. So, ubhayatmikano. Because if Atma and Anatma were one, then Atma is conscious, Anatma is jada, and jada and chetana cannot be one. Atah anatma adhyasta ityartha. Therefore, anatma is that which is superimposed upon the atma. That's the meaning. Ihabi purvardhagam naipadam anupashyate. Here also, the nakara obtaining the purvardha, the previous half of the verse, that so na hidam atma, that na also should be applicable, is also applicable to the second half. Usually that is not done, but anyway, so each half must be independent, but anyway, here, so the nakara must be anukrushyate, must be pulled, you know, pulled into the second half also. So, second part must be read, na atmano avyatirekena yato anatma prasidhyati. That's how we should read that. Otherwise, that sentence will not make sense. So, what it reads, atmana avyatirekena yato anatma prasidhyati. So, it says, that is just the opposite. So the nakara must be understood to be there in the second line also. Then says, Atmana anatma vitirekavat anatma bhi tatah tirichyatam. So you say that atma is different from anatma. Then why should not anatma be different from atma? You see, this rule in the Vyavahara does not apply here. You say that atma is different from anatma. If atma is different from anatma, then anatma also should be different from atma. Atmana anatma vyatirekavat. If atma is vyatirekta, is something different from anatma, tadvat anatma api tatah atirichyatam. Then let anatma also be different from atma. If atma is different from anatma, why not anatma also be different from atma? Iti chet, if this is a question, na iti aha, that is not so. Atma tu, the next verse is Atma tvanatma pratyaktvat vyatirekam nasorhati sarjiva sarpadandadehe sraga vidyotthavastunah sraktatva vyatirekena siddhir nanyatra kutrachit. Atma tu anatma pratyaktvat vyatirekam sahanarhati. If you say that gold stands apart from ornament, why not ornament also stand apart from gold? That can happen, you know. And just as all the sense organs also say it, all right. And so the speech went away for 1 year and said, let me see how you exist without me. Hey, what happened to you? How did you exist without me? Well, just as a dumb person functions, so also we function without you. And Shrotram, the ears went away, the eyes went away, and the mind went away. Just to assert themselves. Let me see how you can remain without me. And so also ornament says, I'll go away. Let me see how gold remains without me, you know. But in a poor ornament, it ceases to exist. In that story, it was said, of course, that the eyes went away and then came back after 1 year, did the yatra for 1 year, as though eyes also existed by itself. Except, but here, so ornament revolts against gold and says, I hate you. Therefore, I'm going to get away. Then it will cease to exist. So, atma tu anatma pratyaktvat. However, atma is anatma pratyak, is the very self of anatma. Saha vyatirekam narhati. And therefore, atma cannot, it does not deserve to be, or it cannot be, vyatirikta cannot be separate from anatma. Because atma cannot be separate from, essence cannot be separate from it, something. The essence of the ornament is gold, and therefore the essence cannot stand apart from their object. Atmana bheda bheda bhyam anatmana siddhyati drushtantah. Atmana bheda bheda bhyam. That anatma cannot be bhinna, is not separate from the atma, nor one with the atma. Tatra dushtanta srajiva. So srajiva, that sraji, eva, becomes two, e becomes a dirgai, Sraj eva. Srak. Srak is, srak means the mala. So example is that normally we say Rajju Sarpa, but here is Srak Sarpa. So mala is lying there and somebody thinks it is a snake. That's how. Srak means mala. Somebody, mala is thrown away because you become old or something. You threw it away in the garden. You also went for a walk in the evening in the twilight and then you got scared because of the snake. But anyway, so Sraji eva Sarpa Danda Dehe. Or if the mala was lying straight, you think it is danda. It's lying crooked, you think it is sarpa. So Sraji eva Sarpa Danda Dehe. Srag avidya utthavastunaha, avidya utthavastunaha. And so Srag avidya utthavastunaha, all these vastus such as sarpa, danda, etc. So Srag avidya utthavastunaha sarpa danda dehe srajiva. So Srag tattva vitarekena siddhi nasti. So srajiva srag avidya utthavastunaha sarpa danda dehe. So just as sarva, danda, etc., which are all the products of the ignorance of the mala, and how they are all superimposed upon the mala or srak, so srak tattva vitarekena siddhi na. So srak tattva vitarekena siddhi na siddhi. All of these sarva, danda, etc. cannot exist apart from the srak. Nanyatra kutra chita, and there is no other way that you can establish the existence of sarva, danda, etc., unless we accept the relationship of Adhisthana and Adhyaropa, not the Vyatireka and Avyatireka. The idea is that these are the common concepts. The mind works like this. That's why the mind is a problem. Mind will say it is or it is not. That's the only categories mind can understand, it is and it is not. But Sadasabhyam Anirvachaniyam, this thing cannot be said of is and not also. Sometimes it is, sometimes it is not. And therefore the mind is boggled. Or vyatirikta, avyatirikta. Either it is one with this or separate from that. But that also cannot be said. You cannot say it is one with it also, anatma, nor can you say it is separate from that. That's why it is said, you know, yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. So words and the concepts of the words, they cannot be, can describe this. So these are concepts. Vyatireka and avyatireka. That's all we know. Bhava and abhava, all we know. Sat and asat, this is all we know. But this does not fall in any of those categories. The whole jagat, nothing in the world falls in that any category. And therefore, nothing can be, in fact, can be determined to be something. And that's why mithyatvam. So atmanaha, so nahi sraji bhasatah tad avidya kalpitasya sarpadehe tat atirekena anyatra siddhi. This is the anvaya of that line. So nahi sraji bhasatah. So saragavidyo thavastunah sarpadandadehe sraji bhasatah. That's all you will say. So nahi sraji bhasatah. So tad avidya kalpitasya sarpadehe. The snake, etc., which are projected or imagined by the ignorance of the mala, and so they were shining in the mala, tat atirekena anyatra siddhi nasti. And so that sarpadanda, etc., cannot exist apart from the srag. Nabi tadatmanayava, nor can we so the sarpadanda, etc., cannot exist apart from the mala, nor can you say that they are one with it. Tatha atmanah vyatireka vyatireka abhyam na anatma siddhi ityartha. Similarly also, the anatma cannot be said to be separate from atma, nor can be said to be one with atma. Okay, we'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Madaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेरि मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरि ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ॐ। विज्ञानमयो मनोमयः प्राणमयश्चक्षुर्मयः श्रोत्रमयः पृथ्वीमय आपोमयः वायुमय आकाशमयः तेजोमयो तेजोमयः काममयो काममयः क्रोधमयो क्रोधमयः धर्ममयो धर्ममयः सर्वमयः तद्यदेतद् इदं मयः अदोमय इति यथाकारी यथाचारी तथा भवति साधुकारी साधुर्भवति पापकारी पापो भवति पुण्यः पुण्येन कर्मणा भवति पापः पापेन अथो खलु बाहुः काममय एवायं पुरुष इति यथा कामो भवति तत्क्रतुर्भवति यत्क्रतुर्भवति तत्कर्म कुरुते यत्कर्म कुरुते तदभिसंपद्यते। सो रीडिंग द करोड़पत्र बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम द बॉटम ऑफ पेज 1199 यस इत्यादि यह शनायादतीतम एक्सेट्रा न तो चैतन्यवत् साक्षात् संसारोस्य स्वतो मतः। क्वेश्चन वाज जस्ट एज चैतन्यम और कॉन्शियसनेस द नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा इज संसार ऑल्सो नेचर ऑफ आत्मा दैट इज नॉट सो इत्यर्थ प्रतिपत्त्यर्थम आजगामोत्तरम वचः। In order to say that, so sava ayam atma brahma, this is being said to show that ayam atma brahma, this atma is brahma in nature and samsara is not the nature of the atma. So to say that is the purpose of this particular statement. Yaccha asya vastavam rupam, yaccha vidyottamatmanah, sava ityadinatasya nirnayah kriyate adhuna. Yaccha asya atmanah vastavam rupam, so that which is the true nature of the Atma, yachyasya avidyottam rupam, and that is the nature which is born of ignorance, sava ityadanatasya adhuna nirnaya kriyate. So by the passage beginning from savai, so this nirnaya, so the determination or ascertainment of what is the true nature of the Atma and what is the nature born of ignorance superimposed, that nirnaya, the ascertainment is being made by the passage beginning from these words. तन्निर्णयात् अशेषः अर्थः निर्णीतः स्यात् कथम् इति विद एन इंटेंशन ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द श्रुति एज टू हाउ बाय डिटरमिनिंग व्हाट इज द ट्रू नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा एंड व्हाट इज द सुपर इम्पोज नेचर और फॉल्स नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा और इग्नोरेंट बॉर्न नेचर ऑफ आत्मा सो हाउ द होल वेदास सो द पर्पस ऑफ द होल वेदास ऑल्सो गेट्स डिटरमिन बाय डिटरमिनिंग दिस टू दैट्स व्हाट द श्रुति वांट्स। संसारी है यथोक्तेन ग्रंथेन प्रतिपादितः तद्गृहीत्यै स शब्दोऽयं तस्मृत्यर्थं तथा च वै। द वर्ड सह इन द सवायम आत्मा ब्रह्म संसारयो यथोक्तेन ग्रंथेन प्रतिपादितः यह संसारी द संसारी हु हैज बीन डेलिनिएटेड बाय सेवरल कंडिकास ऑफ दिस ब्राह्मण एज द प्रीवियस ब्राह्मण तद्गृहीत्यै It is to, in fact, take that one తద్ృహిత్యై సశబ్ద అయం అయం సశబ్ద తద్ృహిత్యై ఫర్ సంసారి గ్రహణం సో ఫార్ ఫర్ రిఫరింగ్ టు దట్ సంసారి ఆర్ బ్రింగింగ్ దట్ సంసారి టు అవర్ అటెన్షన్ ఇస్ ద వర్డ్ సో ఫార్ దట్ సంసారి ద వర్డ్ సహ ఇస్ యూస్ బికాస్ ద వర్డ్ సహ ఆర్ దట్ ఈస్ యూస్ ఫర్ సంథింగ్ దట్ ఇస్ ఆల్రెడీ ప్రకృతం అండర్ డిస్కషన్ సో సంసారి హూ ఈస్ అండర్ డిస్కషన్ ఇస్ వన్ హూ ఈస్ రిఫర్డ్ టు బై ద వర్డ్ సహ తస్మృత్యర్థం తథా చ వై And the word vai is to bring to your memory that samsari. Anatma bhute tasmin karikana lakshane samsare prasade vayam. What is ayam atma? So ayam. Atmana ananyamanagaha. Yaha yathoktena granthena samsari pradipa. No. Anatma bhute tasmin karikana lakshane samsare. Etasmin karikana lakshane anatma bhute samsare. This samsara whose nature is anatma, which is characterized by karya and karana, in that yoyam atmana prasate. So one that is the very atma or the self of this samsara. Ananyamanagaha. So one who is ananyamasva prakasha. So one who is self-effulgent in the very atma, the self of this samsara. So is the one that is referred to by word ayam. Yat sakshikaha. యథోక్తస్య భావాభావో ప్రసిద్ధతః సంసార వస్తునః సో యథోక్తవః సంసార వస్తునః భావాభావో యత్ సాక్షికో ప్రసిద్ధతః ది సంసార విజ్ ఇస్ సచ్ విత్ అనాత్మ భూత కార్యకారణ లక్షణ దట్ సంసార భావాభావో ద బీయింగ్ అండ్ నాన్ బీయింగ్ దట్ సంసార యత్ సాక్షికో ప్రసిద్ధతః సో దట్ ద సంసార ఈజ్ అండ్ ద సంసార ఇస్ నాట్ ఇస్ డిటర్మిన్ ఆన్ అకౌంట్ ఆఫ్ The fact that these being and non-being are illumined by the self or witnessed by the self. So you always require a witness to determine the existence of anything. And so the existence and the opposite of the samsara are determined by which sakshi. So that is the samsara. Soyam atma ityatra abhidhiyate. So that sakshi is referred to sakshi who illumines the presence and absence of samsara. So waking in the dream state, the presence of samsara, in the deep sleep state, the absence of samsara also is illumined by which? Witness. That's the one that is referred to by the word Atma. Sa, Vai, Ayam, Atma. Vivicharona yasyasti sarveshu vivicharishu tas davashtam badas siddhehe vivicharasya sarvada. So this Atma is avyavichari, kutastaha. How do you say that? So, vivicharona yasyasti sarveshu vivicharishu. When everything is undergoing change or transformation, one that does not undergo change. Taddavastambhada siddhehe vivicharasya sarvada. Sarvada means all the time, vivicharasya taddavastambhada siddhehe. The very vivichara, the very change itself, is determined on account of whose presence and who is the non-changing principle. With reference to which all changes are determined, that itself, Atma, is kutastha or changeless. That I am, somebody said, how do you say I am is often referred to for objects such as ghatapada. It says, no, pratyaktayasya sakshatvat akriyakarakatvatah ananya bodhamanatvat I am iti uchyate tatah. So it is not because I am refers to something that is necessarily before you. So, purovartitva bhavat. Usually the pronoun I am or this is used for something that is proximate. And Atma doesn't have proximity. Atma is the very self. So, how do you say there is something that is before you? This is not something that is before you, I am. Pratyaktaya asya sakshatvat. Pratyaktaya because That is the very self and therefore self-effulgent sakshatva, so that which is self-evident. So ayam is a pronoun that is used for something that is evident. And also something that is proximate. How proximate it is? It is the very self. So it is the most proximate as well as something that is self-evident. And that is what the pronoun ayam refers to. Not necessarily that what is referred to by ayam has to be something before me. All that it means is that it must be something that is proximate and something that is evident. And Atma enjoys both the proximity as well as being self-evident. साक्षात्वात् अक्रियाकारकत्वतः अनन्यबोधमानत्वात्, अक्रियाकारकत्वतः अनन्यबोधमानत्वात्। अनन्यबोधमानत्वा मीन्स दैट विच इज फॉर विच द अनन्यबोधमानम्। सो मानव द प्रमाणम इज अनन्यबोध, एंड सो बोध विच इज द कॉन्शियसनेस विच इज नॉन सेपरेट फ्रॉम वनसेल्फ। So consciousness that is non-separate from oneself, the bhana of the pramana, that is self-effulgent and non-separate from me, conscious. That is akriya karakatvatah, because it is neither kriya nor a karaka, therefore it is a self, ananya. And it is bodha of the nature of consciousness, and manam which is evident in itself. So ayam ityuchede tata. That is the reason why the atma is referred to by the pronoun ayam. And that I am does not mean that it has to be something that is in front of you or something different from you.
Nishesh anatma tadhetu nirakarana vartmana atmatvam atmana siddhet na ananya shesham anatma vata.
So, घटादिवत अयम सद्वाच्यत्वात् अयम आत्मा परिच्छिन्नस्य आदेशेत्। सो दिस वाज़ अ क्वेश्चन हियर दैट अयम इज रिफर्ड टू समथिंग दैट इज एविडेंट टू यू, एंड व्हाट इज एविडेंट टू यू इज जनरली दैट विच इज परसीव्ड बाय सेंस ऑर्गन्स, एंड व्हाट एवर इज परसीव्ड बाय सेंस ऑर्गन्स इज लिमिटेड बिकॉज एवरी सेंस ऑर्गन कैन ओनली परसीव समथिंग दैट इज लिमिटेड। सो घटादिवत अयम सद्वाच्यत्वात् आत्मा परिच्छिन्नस्य निशेष अनात्म तद्धेतु निराकरण वर्तमाना। इन फैक्ट द टोटल अनात्मा अनात्मा इज टोटालिटी अलोंग विद इट्स कॉज इज समथिंग दैट इज निगेटेड आत्मत्वम आत्मन सिद्धेत दैट आत्मा। सो द सेल्फनेस ऑफ द आत्मा बिकम्स एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय निगेशन ऑफ एवरीथिंग दैट इज अनात्मा इन द टोटालिटी अनन्य शेषम अनात्मवत। So that which can be negated is always that which serves the purpose of something else. So anatma is that which serves the purpose of atma, and therefore it is dependent, and therefore it is limited. And here on the other hand, atma, the nature of the atma, or the knowledge of the atma is established by negating in totality everything that is limited. Therefore, even though atma is referred to as the pronoun I am, it does not mean anything that is limited, because everything that is limited, which is anatma, which serves the purpose of atma, is negated here in order to arrive at the atma.
Asadharana siddhyeva siddhyasyat atmavastunah.
So asadharana siddhya. What is asadharana? What is specific or particular? A particular thing can exist only when there is something that is universal. So particular cannot exist unless universal is. That the world, every object of the world enjoys the particularity means that there is something universal.
Asadharana siddhya eva atmavastuna siddhisyat.
Atma is a universal principle because of which everything particular is. So the Nayayika said, look upon the universal and the particular, asadharanam and sadharanam, or vishesha and samanya, as something different from each other. So Vedanta says that there is only one sadharanam or nirvishesha principle, and that is atma. And all visheshta is something that is superimposed upon the atma. And therefore, we look upon that samanda as adhisthana adhyaropa. And therefore, non-separate. Inasmuch as adhyaropa is non-separate from adhisthanam.
Yata ataha atvastu eva कार्य कारण जगत, therefore this जगत of nature of कार्य and कारण is something that is superimposed upon the atma, and therefore atma alone is this जगत of the nature of कार्य कारण।
नहि इदम् आत्मनः स्थानम् ततः अन्यत्रापि वा नाश्नुते। Do you say that the जगत of the nature of कार्य कारण is the same as atma or one with atma? No. Or is something that is distinct from atma? No.
आत्मनः न आत्मनः अव्यतिरेकेण यतः अनात्मा प्रसिद्धति।
बिकॉज अनात्मा कैन नॉट बी देयर एज समथिंग दैट इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द आत्मा।
आत्मा तो अनात्म प्रत्यक्त्वात् व्यतिरेकं न सार्हति। Atma tu anatma pratyaktva. Atma is the very self of the anatma. And therefore, vyatirekam sahana arhati. Sarjeeva sarpadandadehe sarak avidyotthavastunaha sarak tattvat tattvatvat vyatirekena siddhirnanyatra kutrachita.
So, the anatma is not something vyatireka, separate from the atma either. Like sarjeeva sarpadandadehe sarak avidyotthavastunaha.
Exist apart from the Srak, and similarly also. So idea is Anvaya Vyatireka, none of them is possible.
So between Atma and Anatma, neither there is Anvaya nor there is Vyatireka. This is what it is. Anvaya means Atma and Anatma being together. That cannot be. Vyatireka means Anatma being separate from Atma. That also cannot be. That is what that's what Vartikara wants to establish here. To establish the mithyatma of the jagat, or the jagat is something that is adhyaropitam, a superimposed. So this is the last verse that we were looking at, in the last session.
Atmani jagatah adhyastattvam samarthaya nahiti. Okay. नहीं व्यतिरेक अव्यतिरेकाभ्याम अनात्म सिद्धि नहीं व्यतिरेक अव्यतिरेकाभ्याम अनात्म सिद्धि.
सो अनात्म इज नॉट समथिंग दैट इज डिफरेंट एंड नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द आत्मा व्यतिरेके निस्वरूपत्वात्.
इफ अनात्मा वेर टोटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द आत्मा देन इट वुड बिकम निस्वरूप मीनिंग इट वुड बिकम नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट. अव्यतिरेकस्य जड़ा जड़यो अयोगा नॉर कैन अनात्मा बी वन विद आत्मा बिकॉज Anatma is jada, atma is ajada, and both of them cannot exist in the same locus.
Ataha anatma adhyastaha ityartha, and therefore anatma is superimposed.
Ihabi purvardhagam naipadam anukrishyate. Okay. Then, atmanah anatma vidirekavat, anatma bhi tataha tirichyadam.
If you say that atma is anatma vidireka, atma is separate from anatma. Then why not anatma also be separate from atma?
The thing is, atma is separate from anatma, but anatma is not separate from atma. This is the idea here.
So somebody says, if atma is separate from anatma, why not anatma also be separate from atma?
So atma tu, so it was said there, atma tu anatma pratyaktvat saha anatma vyatirekam na arhati. That saha should go with anatma. So atma tu anatma pratyaktvat. Since Atma is the self of the Anatma, therefore, Anatma cannot stand apart from the Atma.
Srajiva sarpadandadehe srag avidyotha vastunah.
Just as all the vastus such as sarpadanda, born of ignorance, do not stand apart from the srag or the mala.
Srag tattva vidirekena siddhi nasti.
So sarpadanda, etc. cannot have existence apart from srag. And similarly also, anatma cannot have existence apart from atma.
Now, continuing, we are on the page 1201 in the Tika.
So, atmanah bheda bheda bhyam anatman siddhyati tatra drushtantamah srajiti.
So, that was the drushtanta.
So, Nahi sraji bhasatah tad avidya kalpitasya sarpadehe tad atirekena anyatra siddhi.
So nahi sraji bhasatah tad avidya kalpitasya sarpadehe or sarpa etc. that is born of ignorance of the srak tad atirekena anyatra siddhi.
That the sarpa etc. can exist. Atirekena is something different from the substratum srak is not possible.
Nabi tadatmana eva tat siddhi, nor can we say that this sarpadanda, etc., very atma of the, they are very srak,
tatha atmana vitireka, avitireka bhyamna anatma siddhi tyartha.
And therefore, anatma cannot be as anvitam, as one with the atma, or vitiriktam, as different from the atma. So when it is neither one nor different, then what is the relationship? One of the adhisthana, adhyaropa, substratum and superimposition. That's the relationship where the adhyaropitam cannot be said to be one with adhisthana, nor can be said to be separate from adhisthanam. Now we are continuing with the next verse. Anvaya vidireka abhyam jagatah asiddhi che abhava avasayita iti. Anvaya vidireka abhyam jagat asiddhi. If you say that jagat cannot be established with there either by anvaya vidyatma or with vidireka vidatma, abhava avasayita, that means that it ultimately avasanam, the culmination of the jagat is abhava. That means the root or cause of the jagat is abhava, non-existence. So why not we say there is no such thing as atma, all there is abhava, non-existence, and because jagat cannot be established to be anvitam or vyatiriktam. So if jagat cannot be established to be either of them, that means that the root cause of jagat or jagat originates from non-existence, abhava, avasayita. That's like shunyavada. Because shunyavadins do not accept, they accept maya alright, but they don't accept any adhisthana of maya. We say that maya or a superimposition always requires an adhisthana, a substratum. If it doesn't, then it will, it is no more maya, then that itself becomes a reality. But anyway, here the principle is, our principle is that, so niradhisthana brahmana siddhyati, a brahma must always have an adhisthanam. According to them, a brahma does not have adhisthanam. So, anvaya vidireka abhyam jagatah asiddhi chet abhav avasayita iti. Then it will have avasanam. It will ultimately end up in abhava or non-existence. Will it not be? Na ityaha, not so, na cha iti. So, say the next verse. Na cha abhava avasayi. So, na cha abhava avasayi etat abhavasyapi bhavat pratyang matraika yathatmyat ashrutatvat nacha arthatah nacha etat abhava avasai. So this jagat cannot be said to ultimately have its root in abhava, non-existence. Nacha etat abhava avasai. Not that jagat ultimately reduces itself to non-existence. The thing is, so this, the jagat of the, you know, the world that we have, what does it reduce itself to? We say that everything reduces itself to atma. They would say everything reduces itself to non-existence or shunya. So, nacha etat abhavasai, you cannot say that a nama rupa ultimately reduces itself to abhava, non-existence. Or that there is a total void in there. Abhavasyabhi bhavat pratyang matraya yathatmya. Because just as bhava or something that is existent has pratyang matraya yathatmya. The yathatmya, the truth of anything that is existent is only pratyang atma or atma. Similarly, the truth of anything that does not exist also is only atma. So atma is the truth of anything. For you to say that something is not, even that also ultimately said only with reference to atma, which is. And when you say something is, it is because atma is. And to say something is not, is only with reference to atma which it is. So it is interesting how the truth of something that is existent, so that is why it is said. So abhavasyabhi bhavat pratyang matra eka yathatmya. So just as bhava or existence has its yathatma, his trueness, only in pratyekatma, similarly also abhava, the idea of non-existence also, ultimately involves atma, ultimately involves existence. If idea of something existent, like ghatapata, involves idea of existence, and that existence is atma, so without the idea of existence, we cannot think of ghatapata. Just as Swami would say, you cannot think of a shirt without a fabric or without some matter, some upadana. Well, we can't think of anything without upadana of the material.
But ultimate materialist for a Vedantina concerned only Atma. The clay, etc. is all the intermediate stuff, but ultimate material is only Atma. So we say that without the idea of existence, we cannot think of anything. So we cannot think of any tangible object, which is what we call Bhavarupam, without the idea of existence. Similarly also, we cannot think of anything non-existent, also without the idea of existence. In that sense, we say that Pratyekātmā is the truth of that which is existent as well as non-existent. Then the Tika says, Nachai kincha, jagataha abhāvanishthatmam śrutyākalpade tat arthāpatyāva. Alright. Kincha furthermore, so this is the reason, this is the yukti that we presented. That just as bhava involves, anything tangible involves the idea of existence, so also abhava, non-existence, also involves the idea of existence. So, in short, our mind can never become free from the idea of existence, that's all. This Bhashyakara points out again and again, whenever this idea of shunya comes, he says it is not possible for the mind to ever conceive of non-existence. Because buddhi or the intellect cannot function in the realm of non-existence, it always functions in the realm of existence. Asti. Of course, then it is said that if non-existence were the material cause of the creation, then everywhere we should have the perception of not there, not there, but we always have the perception of there. So ghataha, sanghataha, sanpataha, sanhasti, etc. And so, in short, the mind can never conceive of non-existence. Even to say that, even to think of a non-existence ghata, I must think of an existence, existent ghata. And then somehow, somehow subtract it or delete it from my mind, you know. But anyway, kinche jagatah abhavanishthatam sutyakalpyate. Are you saying that Shruti or the Shastra says in clear terms that the Shunya is the very nature of Jagat or very root of the Jagat? Tat arthapatyava or Shruti arthapatti. So Shruti's statement is there and Shruti could not have made it. So either Shruti says in so many words that the truth of the Jagat is Shunyam, or you derive that either way. Presume. Arthapatti is presumption. Shruti could not have said this unless Shunya was the basis of the Jagat. That's called Arthapatti. Or Shruti says in so many words that Shunya is the basis of Jagat. So does Shruti say in her own words that Shunyata or non-existence is the truth of the world? Or did you derive that, from some statement of the Shruti? How is it? Nādhidhyāha. So then Vārtikara said, Ashrutatvāt. Shruti never says anywhere that Shunya is the truth of the Jagat. Never. Then says the Tika. So, because Shruti does do this, you know. Neti neti ityadi shrutihi jagataha bhavam amrushyanti tasya abhavanishthatvam arthadahayati. So, when Shruti says neti neti, asthulam ananu ahraswam adirgham, when Shruti says that, it doesn't say that this is shunya. In way, asthulam is some entity. Ananu is also entity. So, nainam chinnandi shastrani, nainam dahadi pavakaha, nachainam kledyantyapaha, nashoshayadi marutaha. When it is said that the weapons cannot cleave, and the water cannot wet, and the air cannot dry, and the fire cannot burn, then somebody said, there is no such thing, Atma, because it is non-existent, therefore fire cannot burn. So, no, achedyaha, I am adakyaha, akledyaha, ashoshyaha. There is an entity that does not suffer from being destroyed by the weapon. So, that's a tangible, positive entity. So, when Shruti says neti neti, then, what is it that Shruti is saying? Is it negating everything until nothing remains? Or is it negating something that is negatable? Shruti, when it says neti neti, it only negates the nisheda of something that is subject to negation, cannot negate that which is not negatable. But here the question is, neti neti ityadi shrutihi. Jagatah bhavam amrushyanti. Amrushyanti, so that which cannot accept. So the shruti which cannot accept, which seems to have some kind of resentment. Shruti which resents the existence of jagat, you know. So neti neti. So devava brahmano rupe murtam cha amurtam cha. So murtam neti, amurtam neti. So murta and amurta, sthula and sukshma, karya and karana, whatever there is, all negated. So looks like Shruti resents this jagat, you know, of karya karana or sthula sukshma. So neti neti ityadi shrutihi jagataha bhavam amrushyanti. So amrushyanti, which cannot accept, which resents the idea, the jagat, and that's why it negates it. Tasya abhava nishchitam arthadaha. Even though Shruti does not say that Shunya is the very root of the cause, jagat, but by negating jagat totally, Shruti says that ultimately everything reduces itself to non-existence. Idi dvitiyam ashankya. So arthapatya. So from the neti neti statement, neti neti doesn't say that atma is shunya. Neti neti means jagat is negated. So from that negation itself, we say that Shruti wants that nothing should be left. Shruti wants that everything should be negated, because neti neti, that vipsa is for negating everything. And so that Shruti does not seem to accept the idea of anything that is existent. And therefore, it seems to only refer to or denote. So we presume that this statement of Shruti means that everything reduces itself to non-existence. The verse says, nacha arthatah, not by arthapatti also, can you say that? Baliyasya shrutya durbalayaha tadarthapattehe badhyatum hetumah. Why do you say that? Why do you say that? Arthapatti means, so shruti could not have said neti neti unless it reduced itself to non-existence. So, why do you say that? That is not so. That conclusion of arthapatti is not right. So next verse is, baliyasya shrutya durbalayaha tadarthapattehe badhyatvam. So there is shruti and there is arthapatti. So shruti is always prabal pramanam. So what you say in your own words is always more important than what you derive from the words. So when a person says something, so you said it but you meant that. You can't say that. When something is said, then what is said, the direct meaning, the literal meaning of what is said or what is written, always is most important meaning. Only when it does not make sense or it is not consistent with, you know, in the context in which is said, then alone we have to go for some alternate meaning and not otherwise. And so Shruti clearly says Atma, Shruti always talks about Atma and Brahma and existence of that. So, baliyasya shrutya durbalayaha tadarthapattehe. So, from statement, then from neti neti statement of Shruti, you presume the Shruti means that there is non-existence as a basis of the jagat. But that's the presumption. But Shruti herself says that there is Atma is, and that being the case, so, arthapattehe badhyatvam. Though this arthapatte, this presumption is something that is overridden by the Shruti. So, that's the reason why we say that by arthapatte also, you cannot say that this that Atma is non-existence. Anudyayati. So, next verse is, anudya nikhilam vishvam tat tattva pratipattaye. Atma veti shrutam yasmat natonyat kinchidishyate. Atma eva idameka eva agrasid nanyat kinchana mishada. Atma eva idam eka eva agrasid. This creation, this universe before its creation was Atma, one. Nanyat kinchana mishat, nothing else existed. So idam is what? Or sadeva soma idam agrasit, same statement. But then atma eva idam eva agrasit. Atma eva idam agrasit. So that statement, atma asit, atma alone was. But idam was atma. This jagat was atma.
It's a very important statement to say that this whole universe before its creation was atma, one atma. And nothing else existed at that time. Meaning thereby that atma, the non-dual atma, is the truth of this jagat. Very simple. And so anudya nikhilam visham. By the word idam, so idam refers to the creation which is anuvada of the creation. That is, this creation, this universe was atma before its creation. So this refers to the universe. That's the anuvada. That's only the reiteration of what is known. Idam is something that is known. So anudya nikhilam visham. So by the word idam is included the entire creation, leaving nothing out. Tat tattva pratipatte. Pratipatti means knowledge. In order to know, so in order to derive the truth of this universe, Shruti says in just one word, what is the truth of this universe? For that, idam, this whole universe was atma before its creation. So this whole universe is anuvada of the universe, reiteration of what we see. Tattvatva pratipatte, to derive the truth of that universe, atma eva iti shrutam, that all this was atma alone. This was shrutam. So this is baliyasi shruti. Shruti says that the universe was atma before its creation. And Shruti doesn't say that it is shunyam. So in our own words, Shruti says that atma is the very truth of the universe. And therefore, from the neti neti vai arthapatti, when you derive, that by neti neti shruti means that the truth of the universe is shunyam, that cannot stand before Shruti, which says atma is the truth of the universe. Atma vet shrutam yasmat na ataha anyat kinchit ishyate jagataha shunyatvam anyat iti uchyate. And therefore anyat means shunyam, na kinchit ishyate. And therefore shunya, etc., cannot be thought to be the basis of the jagat, because Shruti says in our own words. So when something is said in one's own words, that is the strongest. Has Shruti not said anywhere, as to what is the truth of the universe, then we would have been in trouble. But Shruti says, sadeva saumya idam agrasit ekameva advityam, sat is the truth of this jagat. So, when Shruti says that, then from some other statement, to derive that Shruti means asat cannot be, because this positive and clear statement is far more powerful than the arthavatti, than the presumption. Like pratyaksha. In our day-to-day vyavahar also, pratyaksha or perception is the most powerful pramana, means of knowledge. And then inference, and then everything else. Only what you perceive, either you don't perceive something, or you perceive does not make sense, or you want to get sense out of it. So you perceive smoke and you want to make sense out of it. Then you use inference and things like that. Otherwise, it's not that you always have to infer. You perceive smoke. If you are satisfied with that, that's fine. Now if you want to know further, why is there smoke? Then of course, you have to use other pramana. Then says the Tika, abhavanishthatvam jagataha nirasya. Jagataha abhavanishthatvam nirasya. So, refuting the idea that the jagat has its nishtha, its basis in abhava or non-existence, so refuting that idea, having refuted that idea, anvayadi nirasam anuvadati. Again, reiterates the anvaya, that there is no anvaya and no vyatirika. Jagat does not have anvaya with the atma, nor does it have vyatirika of the atma, which is said anuvadati. It is just being reiterated, pratyakhyayati. The next verse is, pratyakhyayana cha atmanam anatma vyatirichyate vyatirika svabhavatvat na vichatmani siddhyati. So it is an anudya, because it's essentially repeated, So pratyakhyayana cha atmanam anatma vyatirichyate. Atmanam pratyakhyaya. So negating the atma, anatma na vyatirichyate, it is not possible anatma can stand apart from the atma after negating the atma. Vyatireka svabhavatvat napi chatmani siddhyati.
So, na piche atmani siddhyati, nor can the jagat so get be one with the atma. That's what is explained here. Atmanam vihaya anatmana svyatantrena siddhyati. That's the first line. So, atmanam pratyakhyaya anatmana vyatirichyate. That means, that atmanam vihaya, vihaya means pratyakhyaya means vihaya, atmanam pratyakhyaya vihaya, anatmana vyatirichyate svatantrena siddhyati. So, without the atma, anatma cannot exist independently. Nisvarupatva apattehe. So then anatma was reduced to nothing, you know. So nisvarupatva apattehe. Uktatva, that means what they say. Navi abhinnataya atmani tasiddhihi. Navi abhinnataya atmani tasiddhihi. Nor anatma can be established to be something that is one with the atma. Jadatvena ajada ajadat vyatiriktatva ityarthah. So jadatvena ajadat vyatiriktatva. So vyatireka svabhavatvat. What is vyatireka svabhavat in the verse? Because that means jada is different from ajada. Vyatireka svabhavatvat navicha atmani siddhyati. Since the atma is ajada, therefore the jada cannot be one with the atma because jada must be different from ajadam. And ajadam, so jadam, that is jagat, cannot be separate from the atma because it would become nisvarupam, not can be one with the atma because the one, so ajada and ajada being one location is contradictory. Jagatah anvaya abhave manamah. Same again, the same idea, that jagat cannot be one with atma, for that the pramana is being stated, pratyachastayati. Pratyachaste sutirataha saram neti iti chatmani. Saram atma iti chatatha vyatarekam nishedati. So beautifully Vartikara explains the Shruti statements. So when Shruti says neti neti, what is meant there? When Shruti says neti neti, does Shruti mean that the jagat reduces to non-existence? Is that the intention of this statement neti neti? Says no. Pratyachaste shruti yatah saram neti iti chatmani. So anvaya bhava. All when Shruti says neti neti, it means anvaya bhava. That this jagat is not in atma. That's all. So asthulam ananu, when it is said, anvaya abhava is being said, the jagat is not anvitam, this jagat is not in the atma. So pratyachaste shruti yatah saram neti neti iti atmani sarvam pratyachaste. So everything is being negated in the atma to say that there is no anvaya between atma and atma. Vyatirika bhavamanamaha. And that there is no vyatirika also. So for that, saram atma iti chatatha vyatirikam nishet. And then saram khalu idam brahma. Or atma evedam sarvam. All of this is atma indeed. By saying that all of these does not stand apart from atma. And this is not there in the atma. Meaning that this is not one with the atma either. Most amazing. So it is neither one with the atma. Anvaya is not there. Nor is apart from the atma. Vyatirika also is not there. Therefore, it is kalpitam, it is superimposed. Saram atma iti chatatha vyatirikam nishedati. And so negates the vyatirika. Savayam atma ityetat vyakhyaya brahma shabdarthamaha. Okay. So savayam atma, this much has been explained. Brahma shabdarthamaha. So now the meaning of the word brahma is being explained. Apurvaidi. Sava ayam atma, then brahma. So sahi is explained, vai, ayam, atma. Now what brahma is being explained. Apurvaidi. Apurva, anapara, anantara, avahyam, brahma lakshanam. Which has already come earlier. So apurvam, anaparam, anantaram, avahyam. So that which is not a cause, which is not an effect, which doesn't have a cause, which doesn't have an effect. Anantaram, which is devoid of the idea of insideness, avahyam divided by the idea of outsideness. Doesn't have an inside, doesn't have outside. That means negates the limitation with reference to space, doesn't have idea before and after, negates the limitation of the time. And so, that which is free from limitation of time and space, and Brahma itself, so Bruhatvad Brahma, so that which is everywhere, that which is in fact all pervasive, and therefore negates the idea of the Vastu Parichyada also. So, apurva, anapara, anantara, abahyam, brahma lakshanam. Alright, then, samadhikaranya tatparimaha. Ayam atma brahma. So, this is Mahavakya, where atma and brahma both have been obtained in samadhikaranya. So, uktatmastu svabhavyat, svabhavyat it should be. Uktatmastu svabhavyat, atma brahma, iti atovachaha. This is brahma lakshanam. This is lakshana of Brahma. So, apurvam, anaparam, anantaram, avahyam, this is lakshana of the Brahma. Where does it apply? You take anything in the creation, anything that is creation, anatma you take, apurvam is that which doesn't have purvatvam, which is that before which there was nothing. But jagat is karya and karana always existed before that, so jagat does not enjoy apurvatvam. Anaparatvam. That be after which there will be nothing. That also cannot be said because jagat constantly undergoes change, therefore there is a following state also. Anantaram, there is no insideness. Abhashyatvam, there is no outsideness. And therefore, none of the objects that is called anatma satisfy this criterion, this lakshana. So this lakshana of Brahma ultimately applies where? Only in atma. Ukta atmastu svabhavyat. So sava ayam atma. The Rukta Atma is what? Which is devoid of the Anvaya and Vitareka of the Jagat. So, which is Adhishthana of the Jagat. So, that Atma alone enjoys this Lakshanam of Apurvatvam, Anaparatvam, etc. Sukta Atmastu Svabhavyat, Atma Brahma iti Ataha Vachaha. Therefore, this Vachaha, Sava Ayam Atma Brahma, because the Lakshana of the Brahma are only applicable to Atma. Or they are only found in Atma and nowhere else. That is why, by Samadhikaranyam, the Shruti here declares the identity of Atma and Brahma. So, as we said earlier, many people look upon this as a Mahavakya. So, I am Atma Brahma, when it is said, very often it is this one that is being referred to. However, traditionally it is the Mandukya Upanishad, which is I am Atma Brahma, Soyam Atma Chatushpat, is to taken as Mahavakya. In none of the places there is real context anyway. I mean, you know, even here also, this is some discussion of samsari. And that goes on. In between this is being said. Alright, so that's fine that it is said. But then, the context here is a samsari. Because vijnanamaya, manomaya and pranamaya, actually you want to describe samsara here. In between this is a statement, savayam atmam. And there of course the context is there in Mandukya, you can say, what is it? Om ityek aksharam idagum sarvam tasyova vyakhyanam and so forth. And sarvam yetad brahma, ayam atma brahma, soyam atma chatushpat. There also the idea is to in fact describe the atma. Brahma is a word is only used once, that's all. And that brahma only means omkara actually. Sarvam yetad brahma, that brahma means omkara. Ayam atma brahma means ayam atma omkara. Soya Atma Chatushpat, because Omkara is Chatushpat and Atma also is Chatushpat. Anyway, really speaking, because Om iti yet aksharam vidagum sarvam, you know. All Om iti akshar, this Om akshara alone is all of this. Tasova vyakhyanam bhutam bhavad bhavishadari sarvam omkara tatyaktam, you know. So, trikala atitam tadapya omkara eva. And then sarvam yetad brahma. So, first Omkara and then says sarvam yetad brahma. So, Bhashyakara says that these statements are to establish a total identity. That what is Omkara is this and what is this is Omkara. So, the first mantra Omkara is a word used and second mantra says Brahma. So, there Brahma should be an Omkara. Sarvam etat Brahma, ayam atma Brahma, soyam atma chatushpat, then it would be fine, you know. But anyway, so ayam atma Brahma, that Brahma is referred, is interpreted as Param Brahma. Omite kaksharam brahma, so word brahma is used for omkara. But anyway, so this is, so I am atma brahma, which is a wonderful thing anyway, it is said here. So, okay, uktaide. Ukta atmastu swabhavyat atma brahma idi ataha vachaha. The tika says, samanya visheshadhinam brahma tatra tatra uktam tasya atma swarupatvat atma brahma idi atmana brahmatvam samanadikaran karanyashrutya uchyate tena tayo aikyamityartham. Samanya visheshadhinam brahma. So apurvam anaparam, it is not a karya, so it is not vishesha. It is not karanam, so it is not samanya also. So samanya visheshadhinam brahma. All of this is being said again and again, just to emphasize that the knowledge of Brahman must be devoid of the idea of samanya and vishesha. Samanya, vishesha, all of these are the realm of samsara. And that which transcends the samsara is samanya visheshadhinam brahma. Tatra tatra uktam. In apurva manaparam, in many of the places, this is what the Lakshana Brahma is being said to be. Tasya atma swarupatvat. And that which is devoid of samanyatvam, visheshatvam, and all these Lakshana, the characteristics of Brahma, which are stated in the Shruti, all of them will only apply to atma, primarily apply to atma. So, anya devatat viditat atho aviditat adhi. There also the context is Brahman. Anya devatat viditat atho aviditat adhi. So that which is different from viditam, or that which is different from the known, and that which is other than the unknown. So Vashyakara said, yad viditam tadalpam martyam dukkhatmakam heyam. And aviditam also, ultimately, aviditam is dot which is upadayam. So heyam, aviditam means heyam, aviditam, upadayam. So Brahman is that which is devoid of the idea of heyatvam, upadayatvam, something that is given up and something that is acquired, and atma alone is one, which is not subject to being given up, not subject to being acquired. It cannot be given up because it is my own self. It cannot be acquired because it is already acquired. That means the case, that lakshana of Brahman, ultimately, it reduces, is applicable only to Atma. That is how, that's what is being said here. That wherever Shruti has given the Lakshana of Brahman, it all reduces itself to Atma. Tasya Atma Swarupatvat, Atma Brahma iti, Atmana Brahmatvam, so Atma Brahma, I am Atma Brahma, Atma Brahma iti, Atmana Brahmatvam, Samanadikaranya Shrutya Uchyate. So this Shruti, I am Atma Brahma, says that Atma in fact is Brahma. Tena tayo aikyam ityartha. And because of that, Atma and Brahma are absolutely identical. Katham tayo aikyam? Paroksha sadvetva bhyam virodhad. These very words are found in Panchadashi, you know. So paroksham and sadvetvam. Katham tayo aikyam? How do you say that Atma and Brahma are one? Paroksha. Because Brahma is paroksham. And Atma is sadbhavya. Atma is one among many Atmas. And Brahma is someone different from the Atma. Therefore, that which is paroksha. And that. So, Brahman is advitiya, but paroksham. And Atma is aparoksha, but then sadvitiya. So, that which is sadvitiya cannot be one with advitiya. And that is aparoksha cannot be one with paroksha. So katham tayo aikyam paroksha sadvayatvabhyam virodhat. Ataha pratyaktvam iti. Pratyaktvam brahmanastattvam brahmatvam cha atmanastatha paroksha dvayahanena athyatma brahmeti bodhyate. So pratyaktvam brahmanastattvam brahmanatattvam. So what's the tattva of it? So anaropitam, what's the truth of Brahman? So the lakshana of the Brahman when they're applied will only apply to pratyaktvam, the very selfness. So selfness is the nature of Brahman. Pratyaktvam, brahmanastattvam, brahmatvam cha atmanastatha. And what's the truth of the Atma? That Atma is all pervasive. Atma is boundless or limitless. So, Brahma, the characteristics of Brahma are only applied to Atma, and also at the same time, Atma is boundless or limitless, and therefore, the Atma is Brahma. So the truth of the Atma is Brahma, and truth of Brahma is Atma. The different lakshanas of Brahman that are being stated will be found to be applicable to Atma, and Atma, when also it is looked at, will be found to be free from all the limitations, and therefore, the nature, truth of the Atma turns out to be Brahman, and truth of Brahman turns out to be Atma. Parokshadvayhanena. So, when is the pratyaktvam brahmanastattvam? See, brahmanatattvam pratyaktvam. The nature of Brahma is pratyagatma, that means parokshatvam is discarded, is denied. So, parokshadvayhanena. When you say that, Brahma, the nature of Brahma is Atma, that means that Atma is a paroksha. So, paroksha of the Brahma is that is all negated. So, parokshatvam cannot be. And dvaya, when you say that the tattva of the Atma is Brahma, and Brahma is non-dual, that means dvitiyatvam also is being negated here. So, paroksha dvayhanena hi Atma Brahma iti bodhyate. And therefore, this one statement, I am Atma Brahma. So, negates the sadvitiyatvam of the Atma and parokshatvam of Brahma. The Tika says, viruddha bhagat tyagat aikyam. So, it is bhagat tyaga lakshana here. So, viruddha bhaga, sadvitiyatvam and parokshatvam. So, these are the contradictory elements in the Atma and Brahma and therefore tyagat. So, they are the ones that are to be negated here. Aikyam. Soyam ityatra prasiddham iti hi shabdartha. Soyam devadattaha. There, it is well known as to how the identity of Devadatta, Saha Devadatta and I am Devadatta, how the identity is known by the negation of the contradictory elements. Similarly, here also there is negation of contradictory elements. If one could simply do that, that's all that needs to be done. Nothing else is to be done. If one, in one's mind, one can just say, this is contradictory. Just drop it. If one can do that, that's it. But one can do that in the mind, provided one is doing it in life, because it's very difficult to do something in meditation that you are not doing in your real life. That's all. It's not possible to isolate the so-called meditation in the real life. Because what I think always reflects what I live. So if what I live is contradictory to what I think, it doesn't go too long, you know. Whereas one can partition that meditation section from one's life in some ways by all kinds of jugglery, with the pranayama and this and all kinds of things, you know. You can perhaps do that. And create a suspended condition at that time and do something. But best is that the life itself should be in keeping with what you want to meditate upon, that's all. That's the right thing. That my life, so that dhyanam should not become an isolated event. It's good to do and right, and then it's necessary to do. So that what I do in a concentrated manner then is available for me in the life also, so I can remember. So in meditation I make a resolve, a deep resolve of what it is that I want to live. So that when I live my life, that resolve is available. And then the way I live, that very life is available for me at the time of meditation. But they should not be looked upon as separate compartments. And that's the reason why it is absolutely necessary to completely transform one's life. Although Vedanta doesn't deal at this gross level, at least at a very sophisticated level, therefore it doesn't talk about it. We keep talking only about that, you know, more often than not. But the thing is that unless a complete transformation happens in one's life, it's not possible to gain an abiding knowledge at all. And so, of course, the paroksha jnanam is quite adequate to completely transform oneself and then bridge the gap between paroksha and the aparoksha. But basically, viruddha bhaga tyaga, that's a life. So, life that is recommended or prescribed by Vedanta is viruddha bhaga tyaga. Anything that is contradictory to my nature must be dropped, that's all. And so, whatever is not in keeping with my nature is given up.
If one can have that simplicity of giving up, but the attachment and the, you know, one wants to so strongly hold on to things. Out of total insecurity, one wants to so hold on to one's own limitations and one's own notions. Out of insecurity that one just cannot give up. Otherwise I feel that I'll be in oblivion, I'll be totally lost or destroyed. And so, we with our life, we hold on to things. But anyway, that's the reason why all the time hammering is necessary, that it is not necessary to hold on to anything in order to be secure. Otherwise, that thing controls me. Whatever it is that gives me security becomes my boss, And then, so ultimately that is how the bandhanam, so bondage definitely remains. But it's a process. It's all in the process of giving up. Is a process. It's not a one-shot deal that you just pluck something and throw it away. It is a process.
Brahmana tattvam pratyaktvam iti etat brahma shabdartham anudya prakatayati. So, the earlier verse said here, so pratyaktvam brahmanastattvam brahmatvam cha atmanah tattvam. So, brahmana tattvam pratyaktvam, the selfness is the very tattva of the nature of Brahma. Iti etat brahma shabdartham anudya prakatayati. So, reiterating or repeating.